another intrinsic valuation video from Learn.Invest.Achieve channel, and this one came as a request from Madhafraj Shindi 5237. So thank you for your suggestion, and I hope that you like this video. But before we talk about Tesla, I want to mention that this video is not financial advice and it's for entertainment purposes only. In my opinion, Tesla is a huge opportunity for growth investors and not so much for value investors. You are looking at the 2021 10K report or the annual report that Tesla filed with the Securities and Exchange Commission that we can find and download from the SEC.gov website using the ticker symbol of the stock. So I used the report for this year and a few reports for the prior years to collect the financial and non-financial data to find the intrinsic valuation of Tesla's stock. And believe me, the non-financial data is as valuable as the financial on this valuation, because it helps us to build as much as possible of the full picture and the direction of the company. So in this file, I collected the financial information from all three financial statements, the income statement, the balance sheet statement, and the cash flow statement for the past 3 years, as you can see here. The green rows are data directly entered from the financial statements, and the blue ones are formulas to calculate the needed ratios. And as usual, we start with the question, how does the company make money or what do they do? And as you were expecting, the majority of 2021 income came from selling electric vehicles. But also about 12% of the revenue came from energy production and services. Moreover, Tesla's biggest market is the United States, then comes China, and lastly all other countries combined. And the all other countries form a little over China's market, as you can see in this pie chart. Next, we should check the company's performance in the past few years, and this graph are telling us two things. First, this is a company that is doing well and on the right path to create value for the shareholders. Second, that this company is a growth company and didn't mature yet because the revenue increased about 12 times in only 7 years. And it only gets better because we have the financial statements of the third quarter of 2022, because I'm recording this video in December. And as you can see, the revenue of 9 out of 12 months in 2022 has already surpassed the revenue of 12 months in 2021. So a big credit goes to this company for just this accomplishment alone. Another good thing that we want to see is the cost of revenue is almost matching the revenue growth. And the operating expenses are managed carefully because we don't see any jumps in the past few years. The reason I say it's a good thing is that controlling expenses means higher chances of creating value or earnings or free cash flow to the shareholders. Scrolling down, we see the free cash flow progress in the past few years, and I have to say that this is a beautiful example of a company that proves that it has huge potential for both value and growth investors. Because in just 7 years, the company went from negative free cash flow in billions to a positive 5 billion free cash flow. And 2022 Q3 report shows that the free cash flow so far is about 6 billion. Moving on to the debt, we can notice that it has been decreasing since 2018, and the debt to asset ratio in 2021 is 11% only. Which is an awesome ratio because it gives much room for the company to take on more debt to achieve growth plans in the future. Also, we don't have to worry about Tesla's ability to service its debt because in 2021, the times interest earned ratio is more than 7 times. This ratio is telling us how many times the interest does the company earn, therefore it served the purpose of measuring a company's ability to service their debt. Moving on, there are two things we can't give Tesla credit for, and they are outstanding shares and dividend. Tesla has been constantly issuing more shares to support its expansion plan, especially in the years that had negative free cash flow. So from 2015 to 2021, the outstanding shares increased by about 96%, which means so many shareholders got diluted. At the same time, I don't think it's an issue for the shareholders, because as we will see in a few minutes, the stock price has increased many folds, so the dilution in the ownership percentage didn't hurt them at all. The 2022 Q3 report also shows that Tesla issued more shares in the first 9 months of 2022, so we should expect the same trend in our forecast. A quick thing I want to mention about the outstanding shares is that Tesla had two different stock splits. The first one is 4-4-1 and the second one is 3-4-1. And I adjusted the outstanding shares for this change as if the split happened in the first year of this analysis. The second thing that we can't give Tesla credit for is distributing dividends. And I don't think you were expecting any dividends from a growth company that didn't mature yet, because they need every dollar to invest in their expansion plans. The last thing I want to show you before jumping to the forecast part is the vehicle delivered per year. As you can see in this graph, this could explain many things about Tesla because their ability to manufacture and deliver cars has increased by about 800 times from 2017 to 2021. So for example, it could explain why they are issuing more shares every year, and the obvious answer is to expand and build new factories. Also, it could explain why the revenue and free cash flow has been increasing in the past few years, because again, they are selling more cars. We're going to use this metric, or the vehicles delivered to revenue ratio, to forecast 2022 revenue, because as we saw earlier, 88% of Tesla's revenue is from the auto operations, and it's fair to say that it's a good indication of the overall revenue. Now let's move to the forecast step and put a price on the stock. But I want you to bear with me, because I will do this usual intrinsic valuation and then I will do growth valuation. So for the intrinsic valuation, we need to know the free cash flow per share generated by the end of 2022 year. And the first step is to forecast revenue by using the expected number of vehicles delivered and multiply that by the vehicles delivered to revenue ratio. And in this case, we're assuming that Tesla will deliver 25% more cars than what was delivered in 2021, which is about 1.2 million cars. And the vehicles delivered to revenue ratio will be about 63,000, that is actually the average for the past 3 years, and is also nicely matched the ratio of Q3 2022 report. The free cash flow to revenue ratio is stable in the past 2 years at 9%, so we'll use 9% for this ratio. For the outstanding shares, we're assuming that Tesla will issue 20 million more shares than what was reported in the Q3 2022 report. For the return on investment, this is the only number that you as an individual investor decide and depends solely on you. So we will start with 5%. And the discount rate should be 4%, that is the T-bill interest rate for 8 weeks, that is by the time the 2022 annual report will be filed with the SEC. Which will give us 76 billion revenue and about 7 billion free cash flow, which means $2.23 free cash flow per share. So if we discount it by 4% and use 5% return on investment, it will give us about $42.88 intrinsic value per share. The actual stock price is about $184 today, so we know 5% return on investment isn't what the market is using. So if we change it to 2%, it will give us about $107 intrinsic value. Let's try 1.15 and it will give us about $186.41 intrinsic value, which is very close to the market price today. But 1.15% made me very confused, and I don't think this intrinsic valuation is what's being used by the market. So I realized the market is actually not pricing Tesla based on their earning or free cash flow. In my opinion, the market and retail investors are investing in the hope of having some of this massive growth that we can see in this stock performance chart. This chart I got directly from the annual report, as you can see here. So I decided to use a different method to value Tesla's stock. And to do that, I used the Yahoo Finance website to get the historical stock price data all the way from 2010 to November of 2022. If you're curious to know how to get historical data, I can show you real quick. So after you put the ticker symbol in the search bar and open the company's page, then put the date range here and hit apply. Then you can download it by clicking here. Going back to the Excel file, I found the average price for every day and then for every year to find the growth in the stock price. And the conclusion is that the stock price increased about 166 times in about 10 years, or about 60% increase in the stock price every year. So I applied this increase to the current stock price, which is about $183, to forecast the stock price 1 year from today, and it should be around $292. This suggests that this valuation is better aligned with how the market is pricing Tesla's stock, and the intrinsic valuation is actually not as effective in this case. But I had to show you the intrinsic valuation first to prove that an alternative valuation technique is required. So to sum up this video, in my opinion, Tesla is overvalued for value investors or those who want to invest in companies that create return to the shareholders. But it is not overvalued for growth investors because Tesla is growing every year and has the right CEO to increase the stock price by many folds or at least 60% annually. And before we end this video, please let me know if you have any specific stock that you want me to analyze. And I appreciate it if you consider supporting this channel by subscribing and liking this video.